Hey guys, so I've decided to organize my bathroom and share you some tips and tricks on how to organize and store things in a small bathroom. So if you live in a dorm and you have your own bathroom that's really small, or an apartment like I am and have a really small bathroom. And right now I'm just going to give you a before tour of the bathroom so you can see how things are right now and then how I organize it afterwards. So here you can see as you come in, there's a full length mirror. And then you have the sink here. So I have stuff on the sink that I'm probably gonna get rid of and put it in the cupboards. And I do have a cupboard down here that has a whole bunch of stuff in it. I don't know if you can see, a whole bunch of stuff in there. And I moved up here. This is second floor. I used to live in the first floor. And we just moved, put everything in boxes and stuff, and we just hauled them upstairs. So we didn't really organize them yet. So there's a whole bunch of stuff there that I'm gonna get organized. Here's a medicine cabinet, and we do use it. I don't really like it, but we do use it. And then there's just like a few of my stuff in here, but they're all like mismatched. And there's plenty of room to put more things if they're stored more organizedly. So here's some stuff, not organized really, just put on random shelves and stuff. And in the back here, we just have two hangers for towels. I use this one. We don't really use the one on the top. Here's a hook. You can hook shower caps. Not much there. Here's our two more towel holder things. And we do have a portable washer. So, yeah, it actually fits in this bathroom, which is really awesome. And those cords are for the portable washer. And here is the tub that I'm probably not going to shower area that I'm not going to redo, like organize, because we have our shower stuff, shampoos and shower stuff on the side of the bathtub, because we do have a shower caddy, but it always falls over if we put too much stuff on it. So I'm probably not going to organize this part of the bathroom. Here's just our shower curtains. So I probably won't go through this, but we'll see in the after video what I do with that. And here's just a shelving unit here. Really tall, goes all the way up to the ceiling. There's three shelves, and then there's this bottom shelf here that is like the closed section, which my mom puts her makeup and her skincare stuff, which I'm probably not going to touch because it's her stuff, and plus it's pretty organized already. So yeah, that's basically what my bathroom looks like, and I'm going to be doing an organizational cleanup for the next little while, and when I get back, I'll share with you definitely how it looks like afterwards and some tips and tricks for small bathrooms. I'll see you in a bit. So I finished organizing my bathroom, and I'm going to be showing you a tour of it and some tips and tricks on organizing small bathroom. So here's my bathroom door, and we have a full-length mirror, so you want to look at yourself. Hi. So I'm going to get into it. This is what the bathroom looks like. It's pretty small, as I live in a small apartment, but you can still make do when you have a small spaces. Okay, and over here I have a shower curtain. I just pulled it closed because I didn't change anything in my shower bath area, such as my shampoos or my body washes and how I store those. So I just pulled the curtain closed. And this is a very inexpensive way to get some nice artwork, some nice focal point in your bathroom. If you don't have a lot of money and you don't have a lot of space, just get a very nice shower curtain. And these are very inexpensive. You can get them at stores like Walmart, Target, or even Zellers. And when you're not showering, just pull the shower curtain closed and you have a little nice mural and little artwork on the one side of your bathroom. Here we have a portable washer. If you don't have a portable washer, you can definitely put your hamper there for your clothes, laundry hamper. Another tip is to make use of this toilet area. So above here, it's wall space. As you can see, we have a little storage cabinet thing. And there's a lot of wall space, so it's good for you to make use of it. And this cabinet actually came with this bathroom. I think the previous people who lived here used it. And it looked really gross, so we just painted it white, and it just makes it look brand new again. But before that, we made our own. You can go to Home Depot or any hardware store like that, get planks of wood, and you can get little metal attachments, and you can just make very basic shelving units. So this comes with three shelving units here. You can put whatever you want, and obviously the top shelf to put the least used items. And this bottom shelf here, I'm supposed to remove my jewelry here, not supposed to be in the bathroom, but I haven't done that, so I'll do that right after the video. It doesn't belong here, so this is blank space. the space is really great because it's closed, so you have guests sharing your bathroom, especially if you only have one bathroom in your house. They won't be able to see the stuff, and if it's messy inside, it's fine. This is my mom's section, so I didn't really change anything. She just puts her makeup and her skincare, all the stuff like that. I wouldn't suggest you putting makeup in the bathroom because of the moisture in the bathroom, but if you really have nowhere else to put your makeup, this is a great place, and you can close it and no one will be able to see it, but it's actually pretty clean when she keeps it pretty clean. So yeah. Next tip is your sink area, to please leave your sink area clean and free of stuff. It makes it look larger. When I first came into this place, I've obviously wanted to make use of every single space because it's small. I don't have space. So I want to use this space. I want to use this space. I guess you can see in the before tour to put a whole bunch of things there. But this actually opens up the sink area and makes your bathroom look larger when you don't have a lot of things there. But the one thing I do keep here is a hand wash. This is the Bath & Body Works in Honeysuckle, the foaming hand wash. So people, when they come, they can actually wash their hands. So that's the only thing I would suggest you keep in there. And if you do want to keep the hand moisturizer for the guests there, somewhere here is fine as well. And we have a little clock here so we know what time it is when we're in the bathroom, when I get ready in the morning for school, work, or whatnot. I know if I'm running late. And where I store my items is here in the medicine cabinet. So a lot of older bathrooms or even newer bathrooms all have a medicine cabinet attached above the sink on this area. And I used to think medicine cabinets were really, really gross. I didn't use them. I don't like the inside. They're always gross because I live in really old apartments. But all you have to do is paint the inside and you're good to go. And so now I actually decide to use it. So here, just a little scrubby. When I wash my face, I use that. So on this side is mostly my side. So I have all my cleansers, my night cleanser, day cleanser, my moisturizer, hand lotion, some SPF, face moisturizer, my deodorant, and just different things like that. I put on the bottom shelf because this is the tallest shelf. The second shelf here, I have this little container that's really useful. You can put any of your hair ties, any bobby pins, different things like that. Because they're small, you don't want them like lingering around, you know, everywhere. So it's good to have a little container. I just have my blush and my blush brush because I apply blush in the bathroom so I can see better lighting when I apply it on both of my cheeks to see they're even. And I have my razor as well. This other razor here is a blade that I use for grooming my eyebrows, keeping them in place and stuff like that. And on top here, I don't have anything, but when we have more things, we can definitely fill that up. Same concept. On this side, as you can see, if you're wondering where the stuff from the sink went, they all went on this side. So here we have our cup with our toothbrushes, a tooth paste, and these are other things, my mom things, that they only fit on this shelf because it's a taller shelf, so I just kept them there. And here is another one of those containers. These are tea light containers, actually. You can put tea lights in them, that I use on the other side for hair products. I actually use this here for, this is a razor for trimming hair, and then this is a hair thing for trimming hair as well. Scissors for cutting hair, I mean. And we have disposable razors and other razors for grooming eyebrows. So just extra products here, so I keep them here so they won't be flapping all around everywhere. Second shelving here we have is some stuff from my mom. Some of her scrubs, her moisturizers, her masks, different things, and her favorite lip balm. She has extra, so we just stick them there. On the top is just random things. We have a box of soap there. I don't know why it's there. I think it's just for fragrance in the bathroom. We don't actually use that bar of soap. And some nail clippers, some perfumes, and some mouthwash, some floss, and stuff like that on the top. And below the sink, it used to be a mess, as you can see before, and I actually made it really nice. So what I would suggest you put in here are things that you would use on a regular basis, let's say once a week or whatnot, that you don't need to grab every single day. But we have some feminine products there, and we have some Glad kitchen catchers. What do you call those? I can't think of it right now. Wait, hold on, I'll show you. My brain is not working right now. Oh, garbage bags, that's where it is. I couldn't think of that word for some reason. So these are Glade garbage bags. And here are some hair dye things for my mom. These are just the tools, which I just kept in a box. So some combs and some gloves that she needs to use for hair dyeing. and then this one box of hair dye. Just keep one box, or if you can keep extra toothpaste or toothbrushes, but just keep one extra and put the rest of the extras in if you have another storage area, or else this will get really cluttered. Those two bags are my dad's, so he has his stuff. He doesn't really live with us, so when he comes, he just grabs his bag, and there's like his razor and his toothbrush, toothpaste, and all his stuff that's there. This other one, I decided to use one of these containers that is like for putting leftover food and whatnot, but I don't have the lid for it, but it's easier to store things here when I want to move it. And in the back, we just have another shower head that we got, this fancy one that wouldn't fit in our apartment, a lid for the garbage can, and just some towels in the back, as you can see there. So that's pretty organized. If you have one of a container, like a plastic container, a thing, you can definitely put it here and put your things in it, so it's more streamlined, more nice looking. But this is how we have it, and it's still pretty clean and neat. Last few tips for small bathrooms are making space using wall space. So you can see there's a lot of wall space, and usually you only have a bar to put bath towels. I would suggest getting two bars. The top bar, you can put your face towels or your hand towels and things like that, and you can put your bath towels on the bottom, or you can vice versa, whichever. I only use the bottom one here. And my mom has this side, again, we have two bars, make use of vertical space, so you can have lots of places to hang towels, you know, and you can, this is for hair. Last but not least is behind the door storage. Some people have a whole door storage unit here. We used to have one. It took too much space. I actually moved it to my room, but it took too much space because the door wouldn't open wide to the max. So now we just have a little hook here, and I just hook both of our shower caps. Mine's the pink one, my mom's the polka dot one. And we also make use of the doorknob. I put this hairband thing that I use when I wash my face to keep hair out of my face, and my mom has her hairband for the same purpose as that. So I hope this video helps you and tips and tricks on organizing small bathrooms, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.